Hello viewers, glad to be back again. I hope you all are doing great. Yes, today I'm so excited and I do hope and pray that you guys feel the same excitement while watching this video. You know, there are certain people in our life that impact us in a different way. Maybe we might not know them personally, but we're impacted through their testimonies, their actions and deeds towards us. So today I have in my channel such wonderful and inspirational people that personally impacted my life. Yes, I convey my heartiest gratitude to them. I've been praying for this content and I believe to be all blessed through this video. Yes, today's video will be a little lengthy, but I assure you all that you won't regret watching. So please watch prayerfully and be blessed powerfully. Thank you.
Hello everyone, today I want to talk about self-love, and I believe this is one very important thing we all must understand. And this is also because we are all failing to love ourselves in one way or the other. One is very explicit while the other is implicit. Explicitly, there are some of us who hate ourselves because of who we are, because we are not as talented, because we are poor, because we are lonely, because of our weaknesses and sicknesses. Basically because we compare ourselves to others. If you are one such person, this is what I want to say. Self-love begins with self-acceptance. And I very well know that this is not enough, but I believe that this is the first step to self-love. In doing so, we are actually loving ourselves the way Christ loves us. See, Jesus loves us no matter who you are. He loves you just the way you are. No matter how rich, how poor, how talented you are, He loves you just the same. That is how we must love ourselves. Secondly, I love the very fact that Jordan Peterson, one of my favorite clinical psychologists, said that. He said, compare yourself to who you were yesterday. See, we are not to compare ourselves to others. We are to compare ourselves to who we were yesterday. We are to compete with who we were yesterday. That is to say that we are to push ourselves to get better every day. And I tell you, when you get better every day, you are gonna love yourself better. There's also another kind of self-hatred, which is not very noticeable. See, what do you do when you love a person? For example, because your parents love you so much, they're gonna do everything in their power to make you better. They're gonna push you hard. Or because you love your girlfriend so much, you're gonna take her to the best restaurant. You are gonna give her the best eatery. Now let's look back at ourselves. Do we really push ourselves hard to become better every day? Many times, no. We are too lazy. We are too comfortable in our comfort zone. And many a time we listen to our inner self-negative critic that says you are not enough, that says things are impossible, that says you cannot do it. Some psychologists suggest that because we are so much into loving others and forgetting ourselves, they suggest that we love ourselves as if we are someone else. Sometimes take yourself to the best coffee shop and treat yourself the best coffee. Tell yourself that you are beautiful, that you can do it, that you have the power to conquer. And that is how you love yourself. But here's a warning. When I say love yourself, I don't mean doing everything that feels good to you. For example, lust may feel very good to you, but this is not something right. And in the same way, what your flesh desires may feel so good to you, but this is not right. When you know things are not right, and when you just do them to satisfy yourself, I think you are not loving yourself. Loving yourself is doing what is right. You cannot love yourself more than you love God. And that is what I want to tell you. God loves you so much, and you also must love yourself. God is love, and love yourself. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. First of all, I would like to give thanks to the living God. And also, I would like to thank you, Sister Aline, for giving me this platform. It's okay. Complete remorse morning. ईश्वर एकदम पहला लाइ ब्रह्मन जीवन के भाव राखी दिया पानी के सुख टेंस दिया से मन कोविड 19 कुन भाभी न पापा कुन भाभी सपना दिन पा अचानक दिन तो ना करी मन इस दुनिया से ओ पिता तो ओझा हो जैसे मन सब जानी ऐसे मन बा कुल्बो मन बा पापना सब मन फेलर बनाई जैसे living to some of the body is so Brahman alive achita bhavara khidya so we thanks the asi manu phange saile inala pandemic time the strong relationship feel kura moti ki asi moi khata ra moi kholi munja achi tila life pura life the so bhavara khidya bani so thanks to lagi inala time the ishwar ke mon sar lagi tala Hollywood or prayer itu kita ni dapat boleh buat lagi. Mau kiman sort of relationship build iman sort of mau kita start. Aji mau cok manu papanan bukti nak bayar. Lektin mau inala time ni mau kita is sort of close pun ada. Lektin sort of mau kita start build lah sih. Kita buat good tak kira ni. True tak kira ni, osok tak kira ni. Kiman junior kan itu saya sih. Ombra ishwar janina ishwar lo ekdam close kuna relationship feel kuna thaki de to yang kini khata bra ba se stay home stay safe and God bless you.
Hello everyone, greetings to you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. As such a time as this, when everyone is experiencing life in our own way, it's just a joy for me to speak about Jesus and to give a word of encouragement. Some of you may be suffering from different illness in life, maybe mental illness, physical illness, emotional illness, or even spiritual illness. Some of you may be worrying about your future. Maybe some of you have been a good Christian, but during this lockdown you have backslided, messed up your life and feeling guilty of yourself. Some of you may be in a chaotic situation, don't know what to do. The storm around you becoming louder and greater. There is no peace within you, and yes, if you are the one going through this situation, I want to let you know that God is the source of all the peace, love, and freedom that you are searching for. So call on Him. He will listen to you. Philippians 4:6, it says that, you know, don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything and tell God what you need and thank Him for what He has done. A friend of mine was asking me what to do during this lockdown, and I was encouraging him and also sending some Christian song, you know, like to listen. And after a week, he called me back and said, you know, those songs really, really gave me hope. Those songs are really encouraging him, and now he is listening, he is falling in love with this song, and you know, he is listening over and over to this kind of song. And there's another friend who said, like, since he had nothing to do, I thought of just spending in reading the Word of God, and now the Bible verse which he have been reading, which he have heard so many times, you know, now it is making sense to him. Now it's becoming more real to him, and he start to fall in love with the Word of God. So there are many testimony, but just to encourage you, I'm speaking these two testimony. I also learned that, you know, what we fed to our mind is very important, especially at this time. Many of us are crippled with fear. We have heard, they have been listening to the newspaper, you know, the coronavirus, the death of the people, the positive cases that are increasing in so many things, and they are just so crippled with fear. So it's very important, you know, even if we live in fear, like, it's not going to bring the situation normal. It will be still the same. So why should we waste our time with fear? So it's just a wasted. So it's very important for us to spend time that benefit our soul, that encourages us. So the best way is to spend time with God, to listen to Him, and also reading the Word of God. That can really, really help us. And I would like to end up with this Bible verse that is taken from Romans chapter 15 verse 13, it says, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound in hope. So this is my prayer for you, and I declare this verse over you, that may the hope arise over the fear, may the peace arise over the fear that you are facing through, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.
I want to encourage to all of us through the word of God. Haggai chapter 1 verse 12 says, then Haggai the Lord's messenger gave this message of the Lord to the people, I am with you, declares the Lord. In the Bible we find 1,000 times of promises from God to his people. But let me be wary of you and encourage each one of us. If some of us wondering without knowing the promise of God, let us listen patiently. Joshua chapter 5 verse 14 says, neither he replied, but as commander of the army of the Lord, I have now come. Then Joshua fell face down to the ground in reverence and asked him, what message does my Lord have for his servant? Through this passage, we can understand our God will stand by us as the captain to lead us through all difficult times, like he have been with the people of Israel during the battle at Jericho. Psalms number 23 verse 4 says, even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and staff, they comfort me. Our God stands by us like a shepherd. We don't have to be worried and scared, my friends, because his staffs and root will protect us. Amen. Hebrew chapter 13 verse 5 and 6 says, give your lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have. Because God has said, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. So we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? Through this passage, we can understand that our good God will stand by us as a good companion and helper in times of sin and in times of joy. Therefore, I'm sure all of us must be worried and sad seeing the current coronavirus scenario. But friends, let us not lose hope and faith in God. Our good God has given us promise several times that we are not left alone, he is with us. In the spheres of business, in the temple of worship, and in the home of industry, etc. Therefore, let us walk with him and talk with him more than we have ever been before. May God bless us all through these few thoughts. Amen.